Nationality is the legal relationship between a person and a state. Nationality affords the state jurisdiction over the person and affords the person the protection of the state. What these rights and duties are vary from state to state. By custom and international conventions, it is the right of each state to determine who its nationals are. Such determinations are part of nationality law. In some cases, determinations of nationality are also governed by public international law, for example, by treaties on statelessness and the European Convention on Nationality. Nationality differs technically and legally from citizenship, which is a different legal relationship between a person and a country. The noun national can include both citizens and non-citizens. The most common distinguishing feature of citizenship is that citizens have the right to participate in the political life of the state, such as by voting or standing for election. However, in most modern countries, all nationals are citizens of the state, and full citizens are always nationals of the state. In English and some other languages, the word nationality is sometimes used to refer to an ethnic group, a group of people who share a common ethnic identity, language, culture, descent, history, and so forth. This meaning of nationality is not defined by political borders or passport ownership and includes nations that lack an independent state, such as the Scots, Welsh, English, Basques, Kurds, Kabyles, Tamils, Hmong, Inuit, Maori and Sikhs. Individuals may also be considered nationals of groups with autonomous status which have ceded some power to a larger government. In international law, nationality is a status or relationship that gives a nation the right to protect a person from other nations. Diplomatic and consular protection are dependent upon this relationship between the person and the state. A person's status as being the national of a country is used to resolve the conflict of laws. Nationality is also the status that allows a nation to grant rights to the subject and to impose obligations upon the subject. In most cases, no rights or obligations are automatically attached to this status, although the status is a necessary precondition for any rights and obligations created by the state. Within the broad limits imposed by few treaties and international law, states may freely define who their nationals are and are not. However, since the Notre Dame case, other states are only required to respect their claim to protect an alleged national if the nationality is based on a true social bond. In the case of dual nationality, states may determine the most effective nationality for a person to determine which state's laws are most relevant. There are also limits on removing a person's status as a national. Article 15 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights states that everyone has the right to a nationality, and no one shall be arbitrarily deprived of his nationality nor denied the right to change his nationality. Nationals normally have the right to enter or return to the country they belong to. Passports are issued to nationals of a state, rather than only to citizens, because the passport is a travel document used to enter the country. However, nationals may not have the right of abode, the right to live permanently, in the countries that grant them passports. Nationality is legally a distinct concept from citizenship. Conceptually, citizenship is focused on the internal political life of the state and nationality is a matter of international dealings. In the modern era, the concept of full citizenship encompasses not only active political rights, but full civil rights and social rights. Nationality is a necessary but not sufficient condition to exercise full political rights within a state or other polity. Nationality is required for full citizenship, and some people have nationality without having full citizenship. A person who is denied full rights is commonly called a second-class citizen. Nationality is sometimes used simply as an alternative word for ethnicity or national origin, just as some people assume that citizenship and nationality are identical. In some countries, the cognate word for nationality in local language may be understood as a synonym of ethnicity or as an identifier of cultural and family-based self-determination, rather than on relations with a state or current government. For example, some Kurds say that they have Kurdish nationality, Even though there is no Kurdish sovereign state at this time in history, national identity is a person's subjective sense of belonging to one state or to one nation. A person may be a national of a state, in the sense of having a formal legal relationship with it, without subjectively or emotionally feeling a part of that state. Conversely, a person may feel that he belongs to one state without having any legal relationship to it. For example, children who were brought to the U.S. illegally when quite young and grow up there in ignorance of their immigration status often have a national identity of feeling American, despite legally being nationals of a different country. Dual nationality is when a single person has a formal relationship with two separate, sovereign states. This might occur, for example, if a person's parents are nationals of separate countries, and the mother's country claims all offspring of the mother's as their own nationals, but the father's country claims all offspring of the father's.